In this video, we'll talk about the basic structure of the critical trial events in the experiment. To see the nodes that handle these trial events, we'll go into the recording sequence. The nodes in the recording sequence form a skeleton structure, or template, for the sequence of events that will occur on each trial, with the data source providing the information that determines the differences across the trials. We'll see how the data source information is referenced in a later video in this series. In this video, we will just discuss the basics of this skeleton or template structure of nodes. The first node in the recording sequence is an update attribute action called reset variables. Update attribute actions in general can be used to edit the properties of components in the project. And one of their most common uses is to update the value property of variable nodes. This reset variables action is used to do a couple of things. First, it sets the value of a variable that is used for the SOA duration in the trial by choosing randomly from a range of possible numbers. It also is used to reset the values of three variable nodes that store some behavioral data that will be collected during the trial. We'll cover the details of how to use variables to log behavioral data and how to set variables to random values in other videos in this series. The next node is the display fixation cross action. It presents the fixation cross and two placeholder boxes on the left and right sides of the screen to the participant at the beginning of the trial. In another video, we'll talk about how to use the screen builder to edit the contents of display screen actions. The contents of the display fixation cross action will remain on the screen until the timer fixation cross trigger fires. You can see from its duration property that this will happen after 1,000 milliseconds, and it is this property that you would edit if you wanted to use a different duration. This duration will be the same on every trial, as the duration property is set to the static value of 1,000. Since this timer trigger is connected to a subsequent display screen action, which will change the screen to reflect its contents, it will control the duration of the fixation cross presentation. Following the presentation of the fixation cross, the queue should be presented, and the display queue performs this presentation. The contents of the display queue action are identical to the display fixation cross action, with the exception of the addition of the queue stimulus. Its presentation should last 500 milliseconds, so the timer queue trigger's duration is set to 500. Following the timer queue trigger, the display fixation SOA presents an exact copy of the display fixation cross action and effectively serves to remove the queue from the screen. The duration of presentation of this screen before the onset of the target should be randomly selected at the beginning of the trial. And you might notice its duration property is not set to an integer, like the other timer triggers we've seen so far. Instead, it's a reference to the value of a variable node called SOA duration. The value of this variable is set randomly at the beginning of the trial via the reset variables action. We'll talk more about how references work and how the random value is chosen in other videos in this series. Following the timer SOA trigger, the display target action presents the target to the participant. It's a copy of the display fixation cross action with the addition of an image resource that handles the presentation of the target. Following target onset, one of two things can happen. Either a key is pressed, causing the keyboard response trigger to fire, or 5,000 milliseconds elapses, causing the timer target trigger to fire. The keyboard response trigger is set only to accept input from the slash and Z keys on the display PC. If a key is pressed, then the check accuracy trigger will check the value of the key that was pressed against the correct response column of the trial data source to determine whether the participant responded correctly or not. Two subsequent update attribute actions will set the values of our variable nodes that store the trial's behavioral data. We'll discuss the specifics of checking accuracy and logging behavioral data in another video. After either a response or a timeout, some feedback is presented to the participant for 2 seconds. The feedback possibilities are correct, incorrect, or go faster, and each type is handled by a different display screen action that's connected to the appropriate node path. Once 2 seconds have elapsed, the timer feedback trigger will fire and the display blank action will clear the screen. Note, it's important to clear the screen at the end of the trial, as the contents of the last display screen action that was presented will remain on the screen until another action changes the screen's contents. The prepare sequence action for each trial takes about a half a second to execute. So we clear the screen in order to prevent the feedback from remaining on the screen for a longer period than desired. After the display blank action, the add to results file action will log the values of the data source columns and variable nodes for the trial as a row to a tab delimited text file called results file to facilitate the data analysis of behavioral data. These values will also be automatically logged to the iLink data file when the recording sequence ends. Please see the video on behavioral data logging for more information on how to log this type of data. Please note, it is important to fill out the message property of all the actions and triggers in the project's recording sequence. When a node is executed, an event marker, consisting of the text of the message property, is sent to the iLink data file to mark the exact time of the occurrence of that experimental event. That message can be used in setting what we call interest periods in Data Viewer to focus the data analysis on particular sections of the trial. In this example, we've given each node a distinct label and then simply copied and pasted that label to the message property. You can see the video on interest periods in the Data Viewer video tutorial series for information on how to use these event marking messages to focus analysis on only a certain period of the trial.